frequency of your cars on your own radio station, 89.5. We're going to ask that you toot your horn if you can hear me. Amen. Praise God. I got one witness. Amen. And you might not want to turn your radio station on. That's all right. But if you want control of your own volume and to be able to do it and adjust it as you feel, it is on the radio station, 89.5. Amen. Let's give God praise today. Let's toot our horn. Thank you.
joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sickness.
I'm trading my pain.
I'm laying it down
for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sorrow.
I'm trading my sorrow.
Get there.
Huh?
You gotta praise him till you feel something. That don't have to be going on for you to give him praise.
Hallelujah.
But sometimes you gotta come out of your comfort zone.
Yes.
Just call him Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus.
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 Jesus. Jesus.
Come on, it's not just us in these mics. It's you in your car. You in your vehicle. You on the ground. You in the worship center. You on the YouTube. You on the Facebook. You standing in the corner. You listening in your house. You might be on your job. Come on, give God praise this morning. Come on, work. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to concentrate right now and concentrate on God as we go in prayer. God, right now, we thank you, oh God. You are worthy, worthy, worthy to be praised, oh God. Lord God, we know that had it not been for you, Lord God, none of us would be here today. Lord God, your grace and mercy has shined upon us. Lord God, thank you for your holy kiss for waking us all up this morning. Lord God, we thank you for the joy of the Lord that is within us that you have put in us. Lord God, we declare and decree that your word says the joy of the Lord is our strength. Lord God, we release strength in the atmosphere right now. Strength for those who are sitting on the grounds, for those who are at work, those who are at home, those who are in their homes right now, those who are even in their vehicles right now, Lord God. We send strength right now, Lord God, so that they can raise their hands on the grounds, that they can lift their hands on the ground, they can move their feet, they can get outside of the car if they have to shout, Lord God. If they have anything to give you praise today, Lord God, I declare that this is the day that you have made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. We ought to not take you for granted, Lord God, because I know, Lord God, I'm a living witness, Lord God, that you have done things in my life, Lord God, and I pray that you continue, Lord God, to receive, Lord God, the praises that I give to you. Lord God, for you said in your word that you inhabit the praises of your people. And God, right now, we thank you, Lord God. Those who are watching via Facebook or watching via YouTube or however they're watching, listening, worshiping, talking, typing, whatever they're doing, Lord God, please inhabit the praises of your people. But let us not become comfortable, Lord God. The world is trying to take us away, Lord God, with all these things and trying to shut us up with masks and all sickness and diseases, Lord God. But we bind those things in the name of Jesus. I see on this ground, Lord God, people who have been healed, Lord God, from heart transplants and sickness, Lord God, and bone aches and arthritis and all kinds of things. Lord God, Grace Mary is a church of victory. Lord God, we declare it, Lord God. We know that there's good blood. There's good blood on this ground. And the reason why it's been blood on this ground, Lord God, is because we are through you. And Lord God, by your stripes, we are all healed, Lord God. No matter if it's a financial situation, or if it's a sickness, Lord God, or if it's just marital problems, or if it's children problems, or people in jail, whatever it is, Lord God, we will not be silent. We will not be silent on you anymore, Lord God. Lord God, we don't want to be silent. So even in our giving, let us give more, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, a supernatural increase, Lord God, in all finances on this ground. Lord God, everybody that's on this ground that's standing, everybody that lifts their hands today, everybody that worships, everybody that shuffles their feet, move their feet. Lord God, everybody that does something out of the norm, I ask, Lord God, that you plant a double seed of finances in their pocket, Lord God. A double seed, double digits, Lord God. Seven digits, Lord God, in their bank accounts, Lord God. Whatever it is, Lord God, that you have. It's not always about money, Lord God. Some people just want the good health.
My God.
Some people feel older, they're not even old, Lord God. But I just declare right now, Lord God, that you are the God of victory.
Yes, God.
And we stand strong. We stand firm on that today, God. Because we know, Lord God, that you are the ultimate source. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. There's no name above your name. Hallelujah. And that name is Jesus. We thank you. And we come in agreement, Lord God, that you said that if we can just let every breath.
Yes, God.
Let every breath.
Thank you, God.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, God.
Let everything that has breath.
Everything.
Praise the Lord. Amen. That's the 150 divisional songs, and I thank you for your word. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. And every believer, every soul born out Christian, ought to just toot your horn and just say amen, amen, amen. I heard somebody say, if she don't want her blessing in that car, I'll take it. Yeah. That one, she said. Somebody else said, I'll take that blessing if she don't want it. Huh. Amen. 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 right. I just want to thank God, amen, for seeing Elder James Reed Sr. out here on the grounds, amen. You know, just a couple of weeks ago, amen, that's not about this situation. Hey, but you can tell me God is good. You can tell me God is good. Hallelujah. Ty Trippin said he's the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. He just agreed with the word. That's what the word says. Amen. Amen. We have a phenomenal speaker, amen, coming today, amen, who's going to be bringing the word, amen. And we call him Chief. He'll always be Chief in our book, amen. Deacon Thomas Forward. Let's give him a round of applause for tonight. Coming right now, we just thank God in advance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. We're going to come with another worship song. But you know, we want you all to just, we're already in the second month. And just me going in the store the other day, I saw Easter stuff. I'm like, wait a minute, Easter in March? It's gotta be. It's gotta be. No, it's in April. They already working our minds 2 months in advance. What should we be doing when we give our praise?
My God, in advance. Hallelujah.
If the store can get more money in advance, what should God get more praise than
that? Yes, Lord.
Don't you want your healing before you get sick?
Amen.
Don't you want the check in the mail before your bills come?
Yes, God.
Y'all just receive it. Just receive it. Hallelujah. Somebody gonna come back with a testimony and just be like, God did it.
Yes.
Oh, yes, He did.
Yes.
We're going to come with a worship song, amen. But we just want to give God praise today because He's worthy. And it's just amazing to see Grace Mary's family members. And, you know, we pray for the sick and shut in every week. You know, we pray for those who are even made whole. But to see Elder James Reed Jr. out here, that brings joy to my heart. To see my Aunt Jewel out here, who's gone through some situations, but she's steady raising her hand. Even though tears sometimes may roll down her face. There's a song that she sings that I still have joy.
Yes.
After all the things I've been through, she was called on the precious Lord. There's a precious Lord, and we hold on to His hand. Hallelujah.
Precious Lord. Let me stand.
offering, our tithes and offering. Also, if you have those offerings at this time, our deacons are going to come around. Amen. Those who are on the ground, if you'd like to give, you may have already given online. You just let them know as they come to your vehicle. Or if you're choosing to give online today, we do have our online apps available. That is the Cash App, and that's the dollar sign for Cash App. And that's Grace Mary MB Church. Amen. And then we also have Givelify available. Our Givelify is Givelify. And you just go ahead and download that app. And then at the same time, as you're downloading it, please look for Grace Mary, and you can give your tithes and offering. You can also specify in the little caption in the box what you're giving towards the building fund or seed offering. Whatever you're giving towards, you're more than welcome to put that in that caption, that little note box there. We certainly want to thank you for your cheerful giving. We've been in this pandemic a little bit now, but we got to remember to sow our seeds on good ground. Pressed down, shaking together, and running over.
Yes.
Shall mean given to your bosom. How many of you ever been blessed by money?
Amen.
Amen. My God. Amen. Oh, I don't hear y'all like that. How many of y'all ever been blessed by money? Amen. We like having it, but we don't love it. Amen.
Amen.
Now, how many of you just been blessed just by giving? Sowing a seed into somebody else. Amen. Well, that's what we're here about right here at Grace Mary. Sometimes there's things that are seen, and sometimes there's things that are unseen. But that money goes towards good ground. We're here still feeding. We're here still making sure people are taken care of. We're making sure Grace Mary is taken care of, and making sure that we can still get this ministry across to the nation. Elder Crum used to say we will go out in the Mount of Olives. And then they say we don't have that Mount of Olives. Well, we do have these highways and byways. We got these corner streets. We got the clubs. We got the corners. We got all kinds of things that we can give God praise for. Amen. We thank you for your cheerful giving this morning. Amen.
Amen.
So again, those who are sewing online, our Cash App is Grace Mary MB Church and Givelify. And if you're mailing it, it's 3901 North 37th Street right here in Tampa, Florida. Our zip code is 33610. The same deacons that are around with the pans, with the offering, they're also the deacons if you'd like to stop by here and drop that off. Amen. It's warm out here, but God has given us a chill.
Amen.
It should be a chill. We should feel his anointing, his power all over us. Amen. I promise you, if you give God an advance praise on some things, you already pushing out of the way.
Father God, we come right now to say thank you. Oh God, thank you for what has been done. We know that everybody, Father, wishes to give, but they don't have. Father, we know that you go by the heart. Oh God, we ask and pray that this that has been collected, that it would do what you will have us to do with it. Edify your kingdom. Oh God, I ask and pray all these blessings in your name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much again for your cheerful giving.
Thank you.
amen, the National Negro Anthem. If you know that, we're going to just sing that. We all know the conflict between the regular national anthem, right? No? Right. I was going to say that made national news. Can we make national news today and sing our Negro national anthem? How about that? Can we make news today? That's something we love about. As I grew up, I remember they used to have this little fork, this little pick, go in the back of your head and they say, what did they say? I'm black and I'm brown. Hey, just because you're in your car don't necessarily mean that we have to be quiet. God already knew we was going to be here. Now he just wants you to give him the praise. Amen. We're going to acknowledge our birthday. Amen. All right, we have for our birthday acknowledgments this week for February 28th through March 6th, we have Brother John Alfred Jenkins. February 28th. Amen. That is today, so we say happy birthday to you. We also want to say happy birthday to Brother and Sister Shelly and Gaither Cross, who will celebrate their 34th wedding anniversary, amen, on March 3rd. Amen. Certainly, we say thank you to each of you all, amen, who allow us to be able to just say happy birthday and happy anniversary before we celebrate life. Amen. We're going to sing our National Negro Anthem, if you'll join in with us. Amen. Forward, we're going to have
representatives of Expressions by Grace to come as they minister in a selection. Amen.
Yourself, but don't cry, 'cause better days are. speak to already this morning, for this is the day that the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it, giving honor and praises to God, to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to our pastor, the Elder James R. Reed, Jr., to our lovely First Lady, Sister Sharissa Reed, to all the officers in their respective place. Also to my lovely spouse this morning, and my grandbabies are here this morning to hear and see what Granddaddy got to say today. So we want you honking your horns if I say something that hits home, and back honk them if I don't see it home. But this is a good day.
Amen.
This happens to be the final day of this month, the 28th day of February in 2021. Many who started out this year already, if you called upon their names this morning, they would refuse to answer because their year has already ended. But God saw fit to give us and allow us to see another day's journey. And that we should be glad about. Amen. Before we go into the message that I have prepared for you this morning, let us pray. Father God, again, we come before thee with bowed heads and humble hearts, thanking you, Lord, for another day's journey. Father, we thank you for just being so kind and being so merciful. Lord, we thank you for being better to us than we've been to ourselves. Father God, we just want to say thank you. Lord, we pray that the message that I'm about to deliver, Father God, that it be something that touches the heart, the soul, and the mind of these here, your people. Father God, and let it be indelibly etched so that they can understand the significance of this day, the significance of this period, and why it's so important that we always look towards him. David said, we look towards the hills, from which cometh thy help, knowing that our help come from him that made the heavens and the earth. Father God, we just want to say thank you. These and all other blessings we ask in your darling son Jesus' name. Amen. I want to give thanks to our pastor for allowing this opportunity. Also want to give thanks to the committee and the program chair, Sister Sally Holt Smith, for giving me a green light to participate on the Black History program this year and asking me to bring your message. Thank you for that. The message I plan to present to you is one that many of us have at some point in our lives, some point during our vocations, folk have asked us, why do we have a Black History Month? More importantly, they ask the question, why should we remember what happened in Black History Month? And even to touch home our youngsters today, our youth, because they have not seen some of the things that we have had to see, look at. They have not had to toil through the difficulties that some of us have faced. And they even ask, why do we remember? History gives us the ability to stop and remember significant past events that have shaped the world in which we live. This is why every year the month of February is designated as Black History Month. In 1926, Dr. Carter G. Woodson initiated Black History Month to raise awareness and acknowledge the accomplishments and influential experiences of Black men and women. Black history is not merely the history of African Americans. It is our history as the American people. And our history impacts the church. Renowned Black nationalist and activist Marvin Garvey stated it like this. Marvin Garvey said that a people without the knowledge of their past history origin and culture is like a tree without roots. Many of us can say today, if it had not been for the Lord on our side, where would we be? Where would we be? In Black history, we find a narrative richly woven with the themes of the gospel. It is a history that helps us to better understand God, to comprehend his plan for humanity, and to see tangible evidence of his deliverance, his love, and his blessings. Black history offers stunning examples of what unity should look like, serving as a present-day reminder of the unifying truth that Jesus spoke to both the Jews and the Gentiles. Colossians 3 and 11 says this, where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcision nor uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, bond nor free, but Christ is all and in all. It is a story filled with modern-day faith heroes who persevered for truth, sometimes to the point of death. Hebrews 11 and 1 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. The Bible contains countless historical narratives intended to remind us of the trials and events that shaped our spiritual heritage. Hundreds of verses in Scripture address the idea of remembrance, encouraging us to reflect upon past triumphs and tragedies and recall the God of our salvation. In chapter 4 of Joshua, God commands Joshua to set up 12 stones in remembrance of Israel's miraculous crossing of the Jordan River. The stones would stand as an everlasting memorial to communicate to future generations the provisions of our Lord. They were the faithful witness of a faithful God who understood the propensity of humans to forget. Why we remember. Black History Month serves us and those who come after us much like those memorial stones. It helps us remember to show honor. It helps us remember not to repeat the past. It helps us remember to inspire hope. Remembering the history of the many people, both black and white, whose humanitarian efforts aided the cause of blacks brings them to the honor they are due. Consider Harriet Tubman, one of the many conductors who helped slaves escape from masters to go north and find freedom. Consider the Quakers, white men and women who believed slavery to be wrong and aided the Underground Railroad alongside black leaders such as Leonard A. Grimes. Born to free parents, Grimes became pastor to a church in Boston in the late 1800s, where he shepherded and shared the gospel with black men and women. By remembering and retelling their stories, we honor the courage and example set by these individuals. Why we remember. Being aware of the heartbreaking stories that populate black history helps us not to slip back into the type of thinking that may allow history to repeat itself.
All right.
In 1921, Tulsa, Oklahoma. Many of you recall the story. Few of us had the privilege of having our teachers and historians chronicle the story and send it out to us in truth to make us understand that we as a people, even in those times, merited tremendous skill sets and abilities. But in 1921, Tulsa, Oklahoma was home to the community of Greenwood, an African-American community populated by the wealthiest blacks in the United States. The community, and you, many of you know the nickname, the community nicknamed Black Wall Street, was burned to the ground by whites and Tulsa race riots. Though 10,000 blacks were left homeless after 35 city blocks composed of over 1,200 homes were burned to the ground and destroyed. With all of this happening in America, the event was largely omitted from the history books for years. The story of Greenwood is but one of many similar occurrences that plagued African American communities and settlements during these trying times in our history. Many of you today may recall the story here in Florida of the Rosewood Massacre. This event occurred in the state of Florida in 1923, not too far away from the city of Gainesville. Events like these are hard to hear about, but by committing them to our memory, we help keep them from happening again. We remember in order that we not repeat why we remember. We remember so that the next generation will see our memorial stones and, in the hope of the gospel, strive towards peace and harmony. When we began appreciating the people and a culture made in the image of God and teach our children to do the same, we create a legacy of hope for reconciliation, both inside and outside the church. The history of race relations in our country causes us to feel shame. And our response to shame is to conceal. This is but one reason that I like to frequently visit my hometown in the panhandle of North Florida. When I visit my birthplace, my birth home, and I travel those dirt roads, and I have the opportunity to walk across some of those fields and see some of the hedgerows and the fence rows that my grandparents built and forged.
Amen.
It gives a stark reminder,
yes,
of how far God has brought me.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
I've often.
It's all right. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I've often shared on many occasions with my children so that they too can understand and have an appreciation,
yes, yes,
for what a good God. Awesome God we serve.
Yes,
a God that looks out,
yes, he does,
for us.
Come on.
Even,
yes, sir,
when we don't always look out for each other. God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
And we must not hide our history from the next generation. Standing in the shame-releasing light of the gospel,
yes,
we must share it with our next generation so that they can learn and strive to build and to maintain the strides in racial reconciliation that have already been made. Chances are our children will never see some of the hardships that we endure.
Yeah.
And we can only thank God for that. But it's so very important that they understand that many, if not most of us, were not raised with a silver spoon in our mouths.
That's right.
And faith, hard work, perseverance, God has brought us through. We remember these and we share these so that they remember and we remember in order to inspire hope. Why we remember. I would like to suggest that despite the profound change in race relations that has occurred in our lives over these past many years, when Dr. Carter G. Woodson considered Black History Month to highlight the significance of our African American ancestors, his vision for Black history as a means of transformation and change is still quite relevant and quite useful today. African American History Month is still a beacon of change and hope that is still surely needed in this world. The chains of slavery are gone, but we are all not yet free. The great diversity within the Black community needs the glue of the African-American past to remind us of not just how far we have traveled, but how far there is still yet to go. Why? You can tell a great deal about a country and a people by what they deem important enough to remember, to create moments for what they put in their museums and what they celebrate. While America traditionally revels in either Civil War battles or founding fathers, yet I would suggest that we learn even more about what a country, what it chooses to forget. Its mistakes, its disappointments, and its embarrassments. In some ways, African American History Month is a clarion call to remember. Yet, it is a call that is often unheeded. Let's take, for example, one of the great unmentionables of American history, slavery. For nearly 250 years, slavery not only existed, but it was one of the dominant forces in American life. Political clout and economic fortunes depended on the labor of slaves. And the presence of this peculiar institution generated an array of books, publications, and stories that demonstrate how deeply it touched America. And while we can discuss basic information, such as the fact that in 1860, merely 100 years before I was born, 4 million blacks were enslaved. And that a prime field hand, you've heard the stories, the big buck, a prime field hand went for $1,000. While a female with her childbearing capability brought $1,500. Yet we find few moments to discuss the impact, legacy, and contemporary meaning of slavery. As the African American community, as it diversifies and splinters, it is crucial to find mechanisms and opportunities to maintain our sense of community. as some families lose the connection with their southern roots. I know many folk who have moved to the big city don't like to remember the cornfields and cotton fields and peanut fields and the hay fields that they come from. They'd rather not talk about it. It's not a happy time. It's not a pleasant conversation. But it is very important to our next generation. In fact, it's important to our now generation. Because the communal nature of Black life has provided substance, guidance, and comfort for generations. There was a time when there wasn't a whole lot of 911 calls that we could make, 411s and 211s. Every major call that we made, we went and took it to the church. It was the pastor, the deacons,
come on,
the mother,
come on,
our praying spirit that bailed us out for generations. And though our communities are quite diverse, it is our common heritage that continues to hold us together. So in conclusion, let me reemphasize that Black History Month continues to serve us well, in part because Dr. Woodson's creation is as much about today as it is about our past. Experiencing Black History Month every year reminds us that history is not dead or distant from our lives. The church's recognition of Black history ought not to be based on obligation, but out of our sincere love for humanity. Our love for humanity flows from the love we have received from our God through Christ Jesus. This is why we remember. Thank you, and God bless. Of our pastor and our first lady, and from also from the Forward family, we would like to provide each of you a token of this Black History Month, the deacons. And as we do, we'll ask the pastor.
God praise today. He's worthy of praise because we're still here. We're still here because of his infinite love for us. We're still here because he created us. We're still here because he is the one that is sustaining us. We just give him praise. But after hearing that message from Deacon Ford and why we should celebrate our history, we celebrate it because God brought us through. And you have to know how he brought us through it. It was over 2,000 years ago that he died for us. He went out there on the Roman cross, was pierced in the side. He bled and died. But early one Sunday morning, he got up from the grave with all power. We're thankful for that power because it is with that power that we are sustained today. It is with that power that we are bold enough to claim our history. It is with that power that we're bold enough to share our history. And so it might be someone out here today that don't know this Savior that got up over 2,000 years ago from the grave just for you. You can come right now and be a part of this great family of his, the the one that will bring brighter days to your life, the one that will keep you in all your afflictions and your troubles. You can come right now. All you have to do is get in the comment box that you desire to be a part of God's family. We're going to pray a prayer for you, and you'll be a part of that family right now. If you're in a vehicle here on this parking lot, and after hearing this word, you know that you need a Savior to get through this life, you can come right now. Let us pray. Father God, we come now, God, thanking you for this day. Thank you, God, for the many blessings. Thank you, God, for your keeping power. Thank you, God, for you giving your Son for us, for him to die on that cross and be raised on the third day for our salvation. God, we say thank you. Father God, there might be some this morning, Lord God, that realize they need you in their life. They need you to take their life and make what you would have of it. God, we ask right now that you would save them, Father. We ask right now that you would place your precious Holy Spirit within them, that they might be able to navigate life in a way that is pleasing to you. Lord God, we ask you to do this in your Son Jesus' name. Amen. God is good and worthy to be praised.
We want to thank Deacon Ford for those words today, words for this time that is much needed. Thank you for sharing, Dick. Thank you for pouring from your soul on life's experiences. And you know, sometimes things in life that they just touch us in a different way. And I thank God that we can share all the emotions and the feelings of what we've been through. Why? Because we know who got us through it. And when you know who got you through it, amen,
right,
you can come through anything.
That's right.
So I thank God for that. Amen. And it's much needed in this day and time where we're not ashamed to share what
That's
we've been
right.
through with our grandfathers and our grandmothers, our great-grandfathers and grandmothers have shared with us. Because that's a missing element in the generation now. But we should take those times at the dinner table and share some of those things that we have experienced.
That's right.
And watch us have a better life as an African-American people. Amen. God is good and worthy to be praised. We want to thank also our Black History Month chairpersons, our Sister Sally Hope Smith, Sister Carolyn Upshaw, amen. Beautiful job this month, amen. And I ask us to keep it up, amen. God is worthy of all the praise. I want to thank our music ministry, amen. Sister Priscilla, amen. And Brother Tyrone, yeah. And our praise team, thank you for sharing with us today. Thank you, Sister Paulette, for your role on the social media. Thank you for getting everything out for us. God is good and worthy to be praised. Thank you for coming today. Amen. Thank you for coming. You could have chose to be anywhere, but you chose to be here. We thank God for that. Amen. Amen. We're going to be right back here again next Sunday, 11 o'clock on the ground, praise and worshiping God. We're going to ask you to come out and join with us once again and give God much praise. Amen. And don't forget about Wednesday night Bible study. Amen. You can find us on Facebook and Zoom. Amen. Just go to our page. You'll find the information there to get in and log in. Start participating, and God is good. And let us not forget, on the second Sunday of March, we will have our drive-in family and friends day that Sunday. And so let us prepare and and get fired up for that. Amen. God is good and worthy to be praised. We're going to go ahead and close out and let you go on your way. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this day. Thank you, God, for what you've done here amongst us. We thank you for your word, God. We thank you for the proclaimer of the word. Lord God, we thank you for your people, the hearers. Lord God, what we pray for, Father, is that you make us doers of that word. Help us to make applications through our lives that we might be better for it, Lord God, that you might be glorified and honored in all we do. Father God, we ask now that you would bless your people. We ask that you would keep them and strengthen them, Lord God. Build them up where they're torn down. Prop them up on every side, Lord God, we pray. And Lord God, just bless us as we go out through this week, proclaiming your goodness in this land. Lord God, all this we ask in your Son Jesus' name. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling. May the grace of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us now and forevermore. And all God people say,
when the war is won.